Minnesota now has the largest concentration of Somali immigrants, and many are making a new life here in St. Cloud, which doesn't come easy.
Well, the main issues that the Somali community here in St. Cloud face is finding homes that are large enough to fit their needs. Their family size is much larger than the typical family here in St. Cloud. Typical family sizes are 2.4, and their average family size is 5 or more.
Elizabeth Holmbeck has researched Somali housing in St. Cloud, and she said finding housing that fits their close-knit families, as well as being affordable, are the primary concerns of Somali residents.
The struggles that the Somali people are facing in this community, immigrating from another countries and being able to not have much education as far as how many people can live in a livable capacity, as far as like a 4-bedroom is for 4 people, 5 people, not 14 people.
More space and less money are hard to come by in the housing market. Elizabeth surveyed a small portion of Somalians in St. Cloud, asking if they have trouble affording rent.
The respondents who said yes, they cited being a student, racial discrimination in finding employment, and a lack of jobs, or being unemployed as reasons they had trouble to pay their rent. One respondent said that everyone living in the household had to work multiple jobs to cover their rent.
At the end of the day, you have to be able to afford the apartment. How are you going to do it? There are also other agencies that are working on finding the people a reliable employment. So the resources are there. They're there to help you, to support you. But at the end of the day, it goes back to, can you afford it? And not only Somalians or immigrants are struggling with housing right now, I think everyone is. So
it's very, evident when visiting the cafe.
Raylander,
I worked with the census, and you have